President of the Association, Councilor Chair, Honorable Paul Lim, members of Parliament, distinguished guests, very honored to be invited here tonight. I'm only going to speak for about a minute or so, but what you're seeing here on these screens is a project that I've been working on for about 5 years now. I first went to Cambodia 16 years ago and visited Angkor Wat and many of the archaeological sites. Stopped thinking about it. Still haven't been able to stop thinking about it. So at Monash University, I'm a lecturer in computer games and 3D modeling. And one of the things I've been researching is how to virtualize Angkor, how to look back into the past, how to simulate archaeology, and how to make a virtual world, evidence-based Angkor. I talk to many archaeologists, so I go back as often as I can. What I'm showing you here is some of our latest research that is on display at Monash University Library. This has taken about 3 or 4 years to create. What you're looking at in these images here is a very large virtual reality model of Angkor Wat, where we're taking great pains to simulate all kinds of little people that are artificially intelligent, they make their own decisions. We've reconstructed a temple of about the 12th century, we've reconstructed the vegetation and the houses. All this is on recent archaeological and art historical evidence. It's been quite hard to do. This is, again, I'd just like to say this is on display at the Monash University Library at the moment. One of the reasons I think this is important here in Australia, and this is perhaps very pertinent to the association here tonight, is that Angkor has been included as a depth study topic in the Eurasian Australian history curriculum. So this kind of development of a virtual Angkor that we've been working on and continue working on, I'm hoping will be deployed in the Australian school curriculum in years to come, and also in Cambodia soon after. Thank you very much for your attention.
SK Media.